Pile foundations are classified into two categories. Let's discuss the pile foundations on the basis of their functions. The first type of pile footing we have is friction pile. The name of this pile suggests its working principle, that is force of friction. Friction piles are driven into the ground, allowing the pile surface to come in contact with the surrounding soil. Friction forces are produced between the skin of the pile and the surrounding soil. The produced friction, which depends upon the depth of pile foundation, is enough to resist the loads from superstructure. The second type of pile foundation on the basis of function is end-bearing pile. End-bearing pile transfers loads directly from the superstructure to the stronger soil present at a certain depth. Let's take a look at its construction process. The first step is driving the pile casing into the ground. Then an auger is used to excavate the soil. Subsequently, pile cage is inserted into the casing. After this, concrete is poured into the casing. And finally, casing is removed by vibration and rotation method. After constructing a group of piles, a pile cap is constructed to transfer load uniformly from the superstructure. Here's the next review of the piles. You can see the low density soil at the top, medium density soil in between, and high density soil at the bottom. The third type of pile is sand compactor pile. Sand compactor pile does not take any load. In fact, it's only used to improve the bearing capacity of the soil. A tube is driven into the ground to the required depth and sand is added to the tube. Sand is released into the ground and the tube is extracted and then driven back to compact the released sand. This process is repeated until a sand column is made. These sand columns are made close to each other, so the overall bearing capacity of the soil is increased. The fourth and final type of pile on the basis of function is sheet pile. Sheet piles are most commonly used to resist lateral soil pressure or to retain water or for shore protection and many other such uses. Sheet piles have these hooks or locks which are used to interlock a number of piles. Sheet pile is the only pile that does not provide vertical support. Instead, it provides horizontal support. Now it's time to discuss pile foundations on the basis of material. You have already watched piles made from concrete, but piles can also be made from timber. And they can also be made from steel. Here I have shown a steel edge pile, but it can also be a tube or a box pile. Finally, we have composite piles. Composite piles are made from more than one material or from a combination of two different materials. They can be a combination of concrete and timber or concrete and steel. Please like the video and leave a comment. Subscribe to keep in touch for future videos. Thank you for watching.